Hello.
Hello.
Hello, guys. How are you doing? How are you today?
Bye, thank you.
Hi. Very good. My name is Flor. I'm from San Salvador, and I'm going to be your teacher. This is the level beginner two. So what about you, Ricardo?
I live in Santo Tomas. I am 33 years old. My favorite color is red. I like salsa music.
All right. Very good. Nice. Thank you so much, Ricardo. What about you, Juan Carlos? Hello, Juan Carlos. Juan Carlos. I heard that noise. It's getting me crazy here. What is that noise? Okay, it's better now. Juan Carlos, are you there? Well, he went out. Victor, can you tell us about you?
Hi, teacher.
Hi, Victor. What can you tell us about you? How are you doing today? Where are you from? What's your name? What do you do?
Okay, my name is Victor Cerrito. I'm from Santa Ana, Texas, Tepeque. It's good. That's
okay. What do you do, Victor?
What do you do? Not remember. What do you do?
Okay. Can you ask me the same question?
Yes, same question. Yes.
Ask me. You ask me. What do you do?
Ah, okay.
Ask me the question. What do you do? Repeat. Ask me.
Ask me?
Repeat. What do you do?
How old are you?
No, repeat. Repeat. My name is Flor, by the way. My name is Flor. Victor, repeat. What do you do, Flor?
What do you do, Flor?
I am an English teacher.
I am a student.
Oh, you're a student. Very good, Victor. Yeah. Thank you so much. Juan Carlos, you're back again. Can you tell us about you, Juan Carlos?
Yes.
Okay, what's your name? Where are you from? What do you do? Tell us about you.
Where are you from? Tepecoyo.
So you say, I am from Tepecoyo.
I am from Tepecoyo. My favorite color is blue, red, black. I am a student.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you. Hector, can you tell us about you?
Excuse me. Repeat, please.
What can you tell us about you? Your name, your occupation.
Que le hable sobre tú, Hector. Que le hable sobre tú.
Ah, okay. Well, my occupation is counter. Is I am from Mexicanos.
Okay, how old are you? How old are you?
40.
I am
at 40 old. 40 old.
Okay, good. Thank you so much. Carolina, are you there, Carolina?
Yes, I'm here.
Can you tell us about yourself, Carolina?
My name is Carolina. I live in Baltimore. My favorite color is blue, black, and white.
Okay, thank you. It's a little bit difficult to listen to you and understand what you're saying, but I think we're having some problems with the audio. Yes. Or maybe the internet connection.
Only as the only difficult.
Okay.
Listen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I hear a very strange noise. I don't know what is that noise. It stopped. But suddenly I hear it. Okay, welcome everybody to this lesson. My name is Flor. I work at Inglés Corporativo. I am an English teacher and I'm going to be in charge of this course. As you already know, well, I'm going to say this in Spanish, so it can be heard. So, vamos a, no sé si todos son nuevos o ya habían estado en el beginner uno.
Yes.
Todos ya habían estado en el beginner 1.
Sí.
Okay, well, this is beginner 2, entonces ya saben cómo funciona, ¿verdad? Son 5 secciones. Okay. 5 sections. No sé si ya chequearon la plataforma por el día de hoy.
No.
Okay, well, the objective is... la idea es de que nosotros les ayudemos con los contenidos de la plataforma. Ustedes pueden chequear antes de la clase. Son 5 secciones. Usted puede chequear antes de la clase y si no entendió el tema o tiene alguna duda, pregunta, la solventamos aquí en la clase en vivo. Igual lo que vamos a practicar en cada clase en vivo es en base a la plataforma, ¿verdad? Después de la clase, usted puede ir a la plataforma y practicar los temas que hemos visto del día, ¿verdad? Lo puede hacer antes de la clase para que usted tenga idea del tema y si tiene alguna preguntita, la solventamos acá o lo puede hacer después de la clase. Okay. Es importante que usted vaya completando los ejercicios de la plataforma, pues si usted no los completa, no puede inscribirse al siguiente curso, ¿verdad? Okay, so any questions so far? Questions?
No.
Okay, today's topic is the simple present. That is the topic for today. We're going to study the simple present. What do we use the simple present for, or what do you know about the simple present? ¿Para qué usamos el presente simple? ¿Qué saben del presente simple?
De una acción continua.
Kind of. We use the simple present to talk about everyday activities, normal things in our daily life. So we use present all the time. So el simple present es para hablar sobre su rutina, cosas que usted hace diario o cosas que son normales en su vida o cosas que son hechos, realidades, como decir que un gato tiene 4 pies, si no lo han atropellado o algo así, ¿verdad? Tiene 4 generalmente, que la tierra es redonda, que el sol sale de día, cosas así, cosas que son hechos, realidades. Para todo eso se ocupa el simple present. Para hablar de su rutina o de cosas normales del día a día. Por ejemplo, tomar el bus todos los días, conducir hacia el trabajo, trabajar, tomar café. Todo eso es presente simple. So, and we're going to combine this with transportation in English. So this is some vocabulary that is going to be helpful for us. So let us practice pronunciation first. Let's repeat. Car.
Car.
Motorcycle.
Car.
Motorcycle.
Motorcycle.
Bicycle.
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 Scooter.
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 Vehicle.
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 Minibus.
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 Bus.
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 Lorry.
Lorry.
Train.
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 Airplane.
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 Helicopter.
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 Rocket.
Rocket. Rocket.
Ferry.
Ferry.
Ferry. Ferry.
Boat.
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 Ship.
Ship.
Ship. Ship.
Okay. Those are the most common means of transportation in English. Do you have any question about that vocabulary?
No.
No. Okay. How do you, Ricardo, do you have a job?
My job.
Uh-huh. Do you have a job?
A job in manufacturing is.
Okay, you have a job. How do you get to work?
Car.
By car.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Hector, do you have a job?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
How do you get to work?
I counter.
You take the bus or you drive your car? How do you get to work?
Okay, and drive the car.
Oh, you drive your car. Carlos, yes. Do you have a job? Hello, Carlos. Carlos, do Hello. You have a job? Do you work?
In the bus.
In the bus? Okay, so you say, I take the bus.
Yes.
I take the bus. Repeat, I take the bus.
I take bus. Okay.
Okay, good. JC, do you have a job? I suppose JC is Juan Carlos. Solo veo J y una sola. Is Juan Carlos.
Jonas Carraza.
Wow, Jonas Carraza. Do you have a job, Jonas?
Driving in my car.
Oh, you drive your car to work. Very good. Let's see who else. Victor, Victor Cerritos, do you have a job? Okay, Victor is not there right now. So we continue with the presentation. Okay, we were talking about transportation. Those are the most common transportation means what we were studying. And then we have this conversation. This conversation comes from the platform. Esta conversación también viene de la plataforma. Cuando tengan oportunidad de hacer login y de practicar en la plataforma, la van a encontrar ahí. So, let's repeat. Nice car, Jason. Is it yours?
Nice car, Jason. Is
yours?
Okay, one more time. Nice car, Jason.
Nice car, Jason.
Is it yours?
Is it yours?
Okay, here as you can see, it's like, wow. So the intonation is important. So say, nice car, Jason.
Nice car, Jason.
Now, intonation for the question, is it yours?
Is it yours?
Okay, very good. Nice car, Jason. Is it yours?
Nice car, Jason. Is it yours?
No, it's my sister's. She has a new job and she drives to work.
No, it's my sister.
She has a new job and she drives to work.
Okay, one more time and let's use the punctuation. No, it's my sister. She has a new job.
She has a new job.
And she drives to work.
And she drives to work.
Okay. Is her job here in the suburbs?
Is her job here in
Salzburg? No, it's downtown.
No, it's downtown.
My parents work downtown, but they don't drive to work. They use public transportation.
My parents work downtown.
They don't drive to work. They use public transportation.
Okay. The bus or the train?
The bus or the train.
The train doesn't stop near our house, so they take the bus. It's really slow.
The train doesn't stop near our house. So they take the bus. It's really slow.
It's really slow.
It's really slow.
That's too bad. All right. Do you have any question about vocabulary, guys?
Yes, suburb.
Okay, the suburbs is como decir, los suburbios es cerca de la ciudad, pero no es en la ciudad. Es como a los alrededores de la ciudad.
Sí, eso lo quería. Es suburbios.
Ajá. Sería como en los alrededores de la ciudad. Cerca de la ciudad, pero no la ciudad. Y si downtown, sí es el centro, la ciudad. Okay, do you have any question about vocabulary? Any other question? No. Okay, so we're gonna practice the conversation. I want to hear some of you. Let's start with Ricardo and Jonas. Start, Ricardo.
Okay. Nice car, Jason. Is it yours?
No, it's my sister. She has new job and she's driving to work.
Is her job here in the suburb?
No, it's downtown.
Downtown.
My parents work downtown. But they don't drive to work. They use public transportation.
The bus or the train?
The bus or the train?
The bus or the train?
The train doesn't stop near our house, so they take the bus. It's really, really slow.
That's too bad.
Okay, very good, guys. Nice job. Let's try with next Hector. And Judith, can you hear us, Judith? Judith, are you there, Judith? Carolina?
Hi.
Okay, let's listen to Carolina and Hector. You start the conversation, Carolina. You start.
My car, Jason. Is it yours?
No, it's my sister. She has a new job. And she drives to work?
Is her job here in the suburbs?
No, it is downtown.
My parents work in town, but they don't try to work. They use public transportation.
The bus or the train?
Train doesn't stop near our house, but they take the bus. It's really slow.
That's too bad.
Okay, well done. Very good. Good job, guys. You did it good. Let's listen another two. Let's see, Carlos Hernandez. Okay, we got Carlos and Victor. Hello, can you repeat the conversation, guys?
Teacher.
Yes?
I have a problem with signal.
With the signal, okay. So you think you cannot do the exercise? It's too difficult for you? Okay, Carlos, don't worry. Let's see another person. Judit, are you there?
Okay.
Judit?
Yes, yeah. The conversation.
Yes, Carlos, you start and then Victor continue.
Okay. Nice car. Nice car, Jason. It's yours?
Victor? Victor? Victor, where are you?
Hi, teacher.
Oh, Victor.
Hi, teacher.
Okay, can you repeat Jason's part? Okay, I think Victor cannot do it, so I'm going to do that with you. No, it's my sister. She has a new job and she drives to work. Carlos?
Is her you're here in the suburbs?
No,
it's downtown.
My parents were downtown, but they don't drive to work. Use the public transportation.
The bus or the train?
The train doesn't stop near our house, so they take the bus. It's really slow.
That's too bad.
Okay, well done. You did an excellent job. And as you see, hay alguien que bajó la manita, pero no sé el nombre porque aquí solo me aparece como Galaxy Tab.
Oscar. Hi, teacher.
Oscar. Hi, Oscar. Do you have a question, Oscar? Or you want to practice the conversation? Hello, Oscar.
Hi. Hello.
Yeah, hello, Oscar. I can hear you. Well, I think he's having problems with the audio. Okay, well, listen, I want to explain this and preferable I will do it in Spanish. Because one of the most difficult things about the simple present is that it has many rules. Yeah. So, para hacer el presente hay que aprender bastantes reglas. Es un poquito de práctica lo que se necesita más que con otros tiempos. So, no sé si anteriormente estudiaron algo del presente simple. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So, como ustedes saben, en oraciones afirmativas tenemos acá el ejemplo de oraciones afirmativas. Let's repeat. So, you see, I work. You work.
You work.
He works.
She works.
It works. They work. We work. Como pueden notar, aquí hay un cambio en el verbo, ¿verdad?
S.
La S, ajá, al final. ¿Por qué?
Al verbo, a los pronombres he, she, it, se le va a agregar siempre la S al verbo.
Por ahí vamos. A los pronombres he, she, it, se le llama tercera persona singular.
Tercera persona singular.
Cuando ustedes vean la palabra tercera persona singular, tienen que pensar en He, she, it. En singular, siempre recordar en singular. A estas personas, a la mayoría de veces, cuando estamos hablando en presente simple, le vamos a agregar ese al verbo. En oración afirmativa, solamente en oración afirmativa. Ok. So,
all,
por eso
está all dice, verbs, all verbs.
En todos los verbos que no sean el to be, porque to be es, am, is, are. Eso es aparte. El presente simple con el verbo to be es aparte. Aquí lo vamos a ver con otros verbos que no son cero, estar. So, a la mayoría de verbos se le va a agregar S en la tercera persona singular. ¿Ok? Hay que memorizarse eso. Tercera persona singular, he, she, it. La mayoría de veces le vamos a agregar S al verbo. En oración afirmativa, cuando estoy afirmando, yo digo, he works, él trabaja. Es una afirmación, ¿verdad? Ella trabaja. She works.
She works.
Eso trabaja, tal vez alguna cosa, una máquina. It works.
Una máquina.
Uh-huh. Okay. It works. Trabaja.
It works.
Ajá. It works. So, third person en singular. Eso es oración afirmativa. ¿Cómo?
Teacher, an example. Writer, study. Is a difference. Yeah.
Sí, sí, ahí se cambia el spelling. Ya vamos a llegar a esa parte. Ok, para hacer oraciones negativas utilizamos dos auxiliares diferentes. ¿Me dicen cuáles son?
Don't.
Don't.
Doesn't.
Doesn't.
Doesn't. Doesn't. Doesn't is he, she.
Ajá. ¿Cuándo vamos a usar don't? Con vamos a usar don't, I don't, you don't, they don't, we don't. Con la tercera persona, he doesn't,
he doesn't,
he doesn't, he doesn't. ¿Qué más? ¿Qué más? ¿Qué más? ¿Qué más sucede en la oración negativa? Vean algo por acá, a ver si lo notan.
No hay ese.
No hay ese.
No hay se mantiene el verbo normal.
Se mantiene el verbo normal. ¿Por qué?
Porque solo se aplican en afirmativas.
Ajá. Ya está con el doesn't.
Doesn't es el auxiliar.
Porque solo se conjuga en afirmativa y porque en la negativa uso un auxiliar que es solo para la tercera persona, que es el doesn't. Entonces, como el auxiliar ya indica, esto es tercera persona, por esto voy a usar doesn't, entonces ya no necesito cambiar el verbo porque sería estar haciendo lo mismo dos veces, ¿verdad?
Ok.
El auxiliar ya me dice es tercera persona, por lo tanto ya no cambio el verbo. Porque si se fijan, el auxiliar es especialmente para la tercera persona. Is that clear?
Yes.
Yes. Clear, clear. Let me see if it's clear enough. So we're gonna practice with this little activity.
I'm going playing.
Yeah. So let's practice. We're gonna say don't or doesn't. Okay, Ricardo, can you complete this sentence?
He don't have a dog.
He don't have a dog?
Don't. He don't have a dog.
¿Cómo completo aquí?
¿Cómo completo aquí?
He don't have...
Veamos qué pasa.
Ah, negative. Negative doesn't.
Yes, doesn't. Because it's she.
Mostly.
Doesn't.
It doesn't activate.
Okay, Jonas.
We don't drink coffee.
Oh, wow. Oh, that's the answer. We don't drink coffee. Carolina. Carolina.
Mary doesn't have at home.
One more time.
Hi.
One more time.
Doesn't have at home.
Yes, Mary doesn't have at home. Very good. Let's see the next one. Victor.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, teacher.
You don't live here.
That's the answer. Very good. Let's continue with Oscar.
They don't listen to you. They don't listen to you.
Yes, that's it. They don't listen to you. Hector.
They doesn't tell me.
I.
Okay. I don't tell.
Lies.
Lies.
I don't tell lies.
Lies.
Uh-huh. Okay, who did? Okay. Who did?
He don't. Oh.
Another volunteer?
Don't drive a new car.
He doesn't drive a new car.
Okay, the correct is?
Doesn't.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Recordemos que does not or doesn't va con he, she, it. Let's continue. Cats, ¿qué piensan aquí? Done or doesn't?
Done.
Doesn't.
¿Quién me explica por qué don't o por qué doesn't?
Oh, cats, porque está hablando de muchos gatos. Perdón.
Persona.
Ajá. Sería don't, ¿verdad? Porque está hablando en plural.
Sí, varios.
Uh-huh. Son varios. Es plural. Sí. Por lo tanto, el pronombre sería ellos, ¿verdad? Ellos no vuelan, animales. Los gatos no vuelan. O sea, al pluralizarlo se convierte en they, el pronombre. ¿Ok? So por eso vamos a usar don't. Cats don't fly. Very nice. Good job. Excellent. Now, in this case, it. Don't or doesn't cost very much?
It doesn't cost very much.
Doesn't, ¿verdad? Porque estamos hablando de alguna cosa y es singular. It doesn't cost very much. ¿Y acá?
Don't.
Don't. No, doesn't. Ah, sí, don't.
Ajá, porque don't. Está en plural, ¿ve?
Sí.
Birds don't buy food. Los pájaros no compran comida. Birds don't buy food. Okay, so I hope this has been something helpful for you. And let's continue with the presentation. Okay, so haciendo una recapitulación, ¿verdad? Para hacer oraciones negativas en presente simple, vamos a usar el auxiliar don't y doesn't. I don't work. Primera persona. You sería segunda. You don't work. He, tercera persona, doesn't. He doesn't work. She, tercera persona singular, she doesn't work. It, para cosas, ello, doesn't work, tercera singular. They, it's plural, don't work. We, plural, don't work. Okay. Ajá, let's see. Alguien dijo por ahí de que la regla, ¿verdad? Hagamos de caso, como dice aquí, en general. Aquí dice reglas for the third person singular. He, she, it. Rules. Okay. Tenemos reglas para el he, she, it en oraciones afirmativas. Recuerden que dijimos que solamente en oraciones afirmativas, tercera persona singular, vamos a estar haciendo la conversión del verbo, ¿verdad? En el caso que decimos en general, usted haga de caso que todos llevan ese. Por ejemplo, work, works. It, eats. Play, plays. Swim, swims. Write, writes. Pero veamos las excepciones, porque no siempre va a ser ese, ¿verdad? Al final no siempre va a ser ese. Hay excepciones, veamos. Ok, verbs ending in consonant plus Y. Dice que si el verbo termina en una consonante más Y, voy a cambiar la Y por I latina y voy a agregar ES. Como por ejemplo el verbo study. Si usted se fija, el verbo study termina en consonante. La consonante es la D, ¿verdad? Termina en consonante más Y. En ese caso yo tengo que cambiar la Y por I latina y agregar ES. Study cambiaría a studies. Solo en este caso, porque si usted se fija play, acá, play, solo le agregaron S. ¿Por qué? Porque antes de la Y no hay una consonante, hay una vocal. So, pero si el verbo antes de la Y tiene una consonante, entonces ahí vamos a hacer ese cambio de la Y griega por I latina más ES. Veamos los otros casos. Cry, cries. Try, tries. Spy, spies. Fly, flies.
Spy, ¿qué es spies?
Espiar.
Espiar.
Espiar. Uh-huh. Hay otra ver que es una excepción que si el verbo termina en O, SH. TSH, X o SS, entonces le vamos a agregar ES. Como por ejemplo el verbo go, usted se fija que go termina en O. Entonces le voy a agregar ES, goes. Esto solo aplica, repetimos, para la tercera persona singular, oración afirmativa. Como decir, she goes to the movie on weekend. He goes dancing on the weekend. He washes the car every two days, for example. Como se fija en el verbo wash, termina en SH. Entonces le agrego ES, washes. Watch, este cumple la TCH, watches. Mix.
Mixes.
Termina en X, por lo cual ES, mixes. Kiss, el verbo. Kiss es, termina en doble S. Por lo tanto, kisses. No sé si lo van a copiar o tomarle una captura con su teléfono. Hay un grupo de WhatsApp también, que creo que ahí pueden mandar la captura para compartir. Ese grupo es para que para que ustedes se ayuden, ¿verdad? Creo que ya lo han utilizado anteriormente. Pueden compartir la imagen, sí, la clase, para los que no se pudieron conectar.
Sí, ahorita hay muchos que dicen que no se pueden conectar, que están escribiendo al grupo.
Creo que se les mandó un correo, ¿verdad? Con la contraseña y para poderse unir al grupo de WhatsApp, pero a lo mejor algo está sucediendo porque veo que también muchos tienen problemas con la señal. Esperemos que mañana, pues.
Teacher, teacher, buenas noches. Mi nombre es René Pindel.
Okay, nice to meet you, René.
Ay, thank you. Nice to meet you too. No puedo conectarme, pero a la plataforma. Siempre estoy en el módulo 1. Entonces.
¿Cuándo intento?
No sé, algo.
Tenés que cerrar la sesión, meter tu correo y otra vez la contraseña y te va a aparecer el módulo 2.
Ya lo hice y no me dio, es la tercera vez que lo he hecho. Y
lo hizo ahorita.
No, vaya, pero ¿sí? entonces ahí te el correo que te mandaron, le das clic ahí.
Al link.
¿Al link?
Al link, pues.
Y ahí. Ah, okay. Ahí te va.
Voy a abrir
En la plataforma ya nos aparece el módulo, el 1 y el 2.
Como sí, corre. pero hay que darle clic al
bueno, voy a
ahí okay. Que thank you guys, thank you. Okay, no sé si le van a tomar una captura o lo van a escribir todo esto.
No, screenshot.
Okay, screenshot y lo pueden mandar al grupo de WhatsApp para que los demás compañeros lo tengan por ahí y que le vaya a servir en su momento de practicar en la plataforma, ¿verdad? Porque todos estos ejercicios van a salir ahí. Ready?
Ready.
All right, let's continue.
Okay.
Let's see. In the platform, you will see this. Okay. So those are transportation means. This is more vocabulary. This is the vocabulary that you're going to see in the platform. As you can see here, how do you go to work or how do you get to work? That is the top eight ways to get to work. So you can see, I get to work by car. I drive my car to work. Okay, this is another way. If you work near your house, you can say, I walk home. Take the bus.
Take the subway.
Take the subway. Not here in El Salvador, right?
No.
Take the train.
No.
Ride a bike.
Yes. The bus drive.
Yes, it's possible to get to work by driving a bike. Take a taxi.
Take a taxi.
Or you can say.
And the marathon.
Take a cab.
Right.
You know, you can say taxi or you can say cab and it's the same.
Okay.
You can say taxi, either you can say taxi or you can say cab, and it's the same thing. Yeah?
Okay.
Es lo mismo, pueden decir taxi o pueden decir cab.
Take a cab.
Take a cab or take a taxi, it's basically the same. Okay? Ride a motorcycle.
Ride a motorcycle.
So as you see, the presentation was based on what we did at the beginning, so transportation. And this is the conversation that we already practiced. You will see that in the platform. And well, this is what I was explaining you, the grammar focus, the simple present statement, okay? Esto es lo que acabamos de ver. ¿Cómo hacer oraciones en presente simple? All right? For example, the first one, I walk to school.
I walk to school.
You ride your bike to school.
You ride your bike to school.
He works near here.
He works near here.
She takes the bus to work.
She takes the bus to work.
We live with our parents.
We live with our parents.
They use public transportation. Y como pueden ver acá, estamos viendo cómo han cambiado los verbos en tercera persona en oración afirmativa, ¿verdad? He works near here. She takes the bus to work. Okay. Y también podemos ver lo que ya explicamos de las oraciones negativas, ¿verdad? Que para hacer oraciones negativas en presente simple, nos vamos a auxiliar de esto que está acá, que se dice don't.
Don't. Uy.
Ajá, don't. La forma completa es do not.
Do not.
Uh-huh. Do contractado not. O short, don't.
Don't.
Doesn't.
Doesn't.
Does not. ¿Cuándo voy a usar don't? Con I, con I, you, you, we, they. ¿Cuándo voy a usar doesn't? He, she. Y en este caso, cuando estoy haciendo negativa, no voy a cambiar el verbo. No le voy a poner ese, nada. Porque ya uso un auxiliar específico para la tercera persona. Okay. He doesn't work. She doesn't write. Uh-huh. So you see in affirmative, he works near here. He doesn't work downtown. Aquí no change. Aquí change, no change, change, no change. Okay, she takes.
She takes.
She doesn't drive. No change.
She takes. Doesn't drive.
Okay, let's see if we can do this exercise. Maybe we have time to complete this exercise. In this, you have to complete.
My family.
Vamos a hacer este ejercicio. Lo vamos a hacer en un cuaderno. Espero que tengan su cuadernito por ahí para anotar. Porque estos ejercicios sí ya son basados en la plataforma. Así es que el día de mañana o más tardecito, si sufre de insomnio, mire, métase a la plataforma y haga los ejercicios. Entonces, esto le va a servir. Acá, my family and I, como no estoy hablando solo de mí, estoy hablando también de mi familia. Y no es tercera persona, entonces la opción aquí fue live. My family and I live in the suburbs. Ahora aquí dice, my wife and I work or works?
Works.
Work.
Sin S.
Sin S.
Sin S, ¿verdad? Porque estamos hablando de ella y yo. Somos nosotros. Work near here. So, we work or works?
Work.
Ajá. Sin work. S. Sin S, ¿verdad? Work.
Yes.
To work. Our daughter, Emily.
Works.
Ahí sí, work. Con S, ¿verdad? Porque estoy hablando de ella solita, de Emily. She works downtown. So she
drives
to work. Uh-huh. She drives to work. Our son.
Don't.
No, porque el hijo es
nuestro.
No, aquí dice nuestro hijo, pero estoy hablando de él, de nuestro hijo, él.
Doesn't.
Sería doesn't, porque es tercera persona singular, él, our son. Estoy hablando de él. Entonces, para él uso doesn't. Doesn't drive. He, ahora esta oración es afirmativa. He
rides.
Ajá. His bike to school. Y aquí podemos chequear, ¿verdad?
He rides.
Ok, aquí está el ejercicio ya completo. My family and I live in the suburbs. My wife and I work near here, so we walk to work. Our daughter Emily works downtown, so she drives to work. Our son doesn't drive. He rides his bike to school. Okay, les dejo 5 minutos para que hagan el número 2. 5 minutes.
My parents live in the city. My mother takes a train.
I live in the city. My mother takes a train to work. My father is.
He also uses public transportation, they don't need a car.
My parents live.
My parents live in the city. My mother takes a train. My father is already.
As my parents live in the city, mother.
Yes, it doesn't.
The city mother
takes
a train to work. My father is already.
He also uses public transportation, so they don't need a car.
Do you want to check your answers?
Yes.
Okay, there you have the answers. My parents live. Porque son dos personas, no necesitas sí.
In the city, my mother takes.
Ajá, porque estoy hablando de ella, solo de ella. My mother takes a train to work. My father is retired, so he doesn't work now. He also, como hablo de él, uses public transportation. So they don't need a car. Okay, homework for tomorrow.
Okay.
Can you do a little paragraph like this one? Tal vez le pueden tomar fotito y hacer un parrafito así como ese acerca de ustedes usando present simple for tomorrow. And that's it, people. We finished.
Okay.
So tomorrow we will continue talking about the simple present. Mañana seguimos con este tema. Practiquen en la plataforma hasta donde puedan, ¿verdad? Simple present hasta donde puedan, ¿ok? Los ejercicios relacionados a la clase de ahora. Y si les surge algún problema y se pueden ayudar ahí por chat, háganlo. Y si de plano no entendió, lo vemos en la clase mañana, ¿ok?
Ok.
Okay, guys, nice meeting you and see you tomorrow. Okay?
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Okay, bye.
Bye, teacher.
Bye, rest a lot. Have a delicious dinner and sleep well.
Okay,
bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.